another nice example of measuring a sediment concentration in a river. Let me read through the example. After rainfall, the sediment concentration at a certain point in a river increases at the rate of 100 parts per million per hour. So, look at the sentence here. At the rate of 100 parts per million per hour at a certain point. So, it tells you the local rate of change of. So, sediment concentration, you can just imagine some concentration. We will use a letter C. At a certain point increases at the rate of 100 parts. So, dou C by dou T, okay, is given by this. In addition, the sediment concentration increases with the distance downstream as a result of influx from tributary streams. So, this is the spatial variation. This rate of increase is 50 ppm per kilometer. You are given at a point what is the rate of change of sediment concentration. I will just use the word concentration. Okay. And then what is the concentration increase as you move down. And you are also given the velocity of the stream. Stream flows at 0.5 kilometers per hour. Okay. Now, you want to measure the concentration. A boat is used to survey the sediment concentration, because you like to measure the surface concentration in the entire region. So, you cannot be at a particular point. That is the advantage of this Lagrangian way of measurement. You can move around and measure. Otherwise, you require a lot of sensors. If it is time varying, then you require simultaneous sensors at several locations. If it is steady state, you can use one sensor here, 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 etcetera, one by one and measure. But time, if concentration is varying at with respect to time, then you can use one sensor. You require several sensors from the Eulerian viewpoint. Lagrangian, you can move around and then measure. Something like in the example of pollutant measurement, you require several sensors at spatial location to measure the concentration as a function of time. Instead of that, let us say you travel on a motorcycle and then measure the concentration, then you travel and that becomes a Lagrangian viewpoint. Okay? Okay. Now, the operator is amazed is to find three different apparent rates of change of sediment concentration. Why apparent? That depends on how he is moving. So, it is apparent change of sediment concentration when the boat travels upstream, drifts the current and travels downstream. So, one time is going along the stream, against the stream, another time is just drifting with the stream. Okay. Explain physically why the different rates are observed. And you are given the speed of the boat is 2.5 kilometers per hour, compute these three rates of change. Okay. So, very good example, it is an exercise from Fox and McDonald. Now, before doing this example, let us look at another interesting slide. So, now the slide says types of derivatives and then shows some three photographs all from Wiki Commons. Probably you may remember participating in a contest where they show some photographs and identify common theme between them, etcetera. Common theme is there, types of derivatives. Now you have to match the derivatives with the photographs. Now, first photograph shows a small bridge, second shows a motorboat, third I was lucky enough to get somebody doing a fishing there, and it shows a canoe which is not a motorboat, you will have to pedal it. Now, why these examples, why these photographs? Let us look at the first line. Observation of fish concentration in Mississippi River. One, why fish concentration, why Mississippi River? All these are one simple reason. Want to illustrate the discussion in the book by Bert Stewart Lightfoot. The concentration taken there is fish concentration. The river taken as Mississippi River. These may not be, certainly not Mississippi River. But to illustrate that taken fish concentration Mississippi River compared to taking a Ganges or a Kaveri here. Okay. Now, first derivative is partial derivative. Partial derivative is at a particular location. So, what do? You imagine that you stand here and measure the fish concentration and you are at a particular location. Fish concentration may change and what you are measuring is the local rate of change of concentration. The reason for explaining this now is that this discussion and the example are very much analogous. There sediment concentration, here it is the fish concentration, very analogous. Now, of course, want to project what is given in Bert Stewart Lightfoot also. And the next derivative is a total derivative. Remember, when we derived the expression for substantial derivative, we said it is also a total derivative. Given the derivation, we said it is a total derivative dv by dt. It's a function of x particle, y particle, z particle, t, etcetera. It's a total derivative. Only difference is that the velocity there is the fluid velocity. Okay. So, now what I have shown, in general, total derivative is also given by the same expression. What is the difference here? Of course, written for concentration, this velocity is not equal to the fluid velocity, some velocity. The example given by when the measurement of pollutant in the road, you travel in a bike, the velocity of the bike, let us say it is almost still air, etcetera, then the velocity of your bike will be the velocity to be substituted here. In this particular case, you are going to substitute the velocity of the boat, that is why the subscript here says B. Okay. So, in the second case, you go in a motor boat that has its own velocity, that is example also given here. So, it has its own x component, let us say y component, z component of velocity. These are not necessarily same as that of the fluid velocity. So, total derivative is a more generic total derivative. A special case of that is the substantial derivative, where these are same as the fluid velocities. I want to really distinguish this, because throughout the course we are going to come across only substantial derivative, which is following the fluid motion. When you are saying following the fluid motion, it cannot be some other velocity. But total derivative is a more generic total derivative, where these velocities necessarily need not be the fluid velocity. But here, remember, Vx, Vy, Vz are the local fluid velocities. Okay. And that is what happens in this case. You go in a canoe, but to repeat the sentence there given in the book, you do not feel energetic. You just float along the stream. You do not pedal. Okay. If you pedal, that may have some other velocity. Just get along that. You, wherever your stream takes, you just follow that. So, which means that the velocity at which you are measuring the concentration of the fish is same as that of the fluid velocity. So, in this case, you are at a particular location. Here you are moving, but at some other velocity not equal to the velocity of the stream, but here you are just floating along with that. And this is substantial derivative, which you are going to come across throughout the course, dc by dt. Some books do not differentiate, but some books differentiate. We will differentiate. Dc by dt represents substantial derivative. Okay. But now, let us return back to the example. I think all the physics is clear. Instead of fish, we have sediment, we will have to use the appropriate velocities. Okay. Now, the substantial derivative of concentration is given by this expression. For you to get slowly used to the vectorial notation, I have specifically used the vectorial representation. Now, in this particular case, it is some rate of change of concentration, not that following the fluid motion. So, this V becomes Vb here. V represents boat here. Now, we will just take one dimensional case. So, Vyb is 0, Vzb is 0, and Vb dot the gradient gets simplified. You will have only one term there, as we have done earlier case also. So, only the first term remains. You do not have this, you do not have this. So, only the first term remains. Okay. So, the expression for the rate of change of concentration, I do not call this as substantial derivative of concentration. One of the special cases, substantial derivative. I just call rate of change of concentration is given by this expression. It has two components, that is still there. Conceptually, it is same. Please remember that. It has a local component, it has a convective component, but that convection takes place at different rates, different velocities. Okay. Okay, now, what is that we are given? We are given in the question set, at a particular location, the rate of change of sediment concentration is such a value. So, dou c by dou t is this. And then, as you travel, there is a change in concentration, and that is given by dou c by dou x. What is the change of concentration with respect to distance? Look at the unit, ppm per hour, ppm per kilometer per distance. Now, velocity of the stream was given to us, Vs, 0.5 kilometer per hour. Speed of the boat is given as Vbr. I will explain why I mean by Vbr as 2.5 kilometer per hour. Okay. Now, whenever you specify speed of a boat, it is customary that it is represented with respect to the stream velocity. Okay. Now, you are moving the stream, all the velocities of boat reported are with respect to the stream velocity. But what you like to know is the velocity of the boat from a stationary point of view. Suppose if you stand on the shore and observe the boat, what is its velocity? That is why I use notation VBR relative to the stream velocity. Okay. Let us put that in terms of expressions. VBR represents relative velocity, the velocity of the boat relative to the stream velocity. Now, to obtain the rate of change of concentration as measured from the boat, this, remember, these velocities are all with respect to stationary observer. What do you mean stationary observer? You stand on the shore, you are not moving along with the boat. You are on the shore, you are observing what is the velocity of the boat. So, what should you do? This is velocity given with relative to the stream. So, you add the stream velocity. Looking at the other way, this relative velocity is given as the velocity of the boat subtracted, and then you subtract the stream velocity. Relative to the stream velocity, what is the velocity of the boat? That is the value given to you. To get the actual velocity, meaning velocity as a station observer on the shore would observe, you will have to add the stream velocity. And of course, taking in the relative directions into account. Whether it is going along with stream or against a stream, etcetera. Now, I explained the nomenclature very clearly here. Vs is the velocity of the stream, because we are considering only one direction. Let us take it is moving in the positive x direction as is shown here. Okay. Now, velocity of the boat relative to the stream and related to the stream velocity. And that is also in the positive x direction. So, suppose if it is moving negative direction, I should take a minus sign for that. And Vxb as I have been telling you is the velocity of the boat relative to the shore. Relative, more formally, we do not say shore in formal language, we say stationary observer. So, somebody is fixed to the ground, okay, in the positive x direction. Okay. So that makes our sign convention very clear. Okay, so now once all these are clear, we can answer the three cases given. Okay. First it says the for travel upstream. The upstream means that the boat is traveling against the stream. That is a terminology used. When you say upstream, a stream goes in the positive x direction, boat moves opposite to that, upstream to that. So, moves in the negative x direction. So, velocity of the boat, as we have seen, we have to add to the velocity of the boat relative to the station observer is equal to the velocity of the boat relative to the stream plus the stream velocity. Now, because the boat is moving in the negative x direction, I used a minus 2.5 here. And stream, of course, we are taken to move in the positive x direction. So, plus 0.5 giving us minus 2 kilometer per hour. That is the velocity of the boat as observed from the shore or station observer. So, now simple substitution, rate of change of concentration as measured sitting on the boat, which is moving at the rate of 2 kilometer per hour in the negative x direction as observed from the shore. And so, dou c by dou t is value given to us 100, and then Vxb is minus 2, and the rate of change of concentration with respect to distance is given to us just tells 0. Okay. So, if you are moving at the boat at these conditions, and suppose if you have something called the sedimentation meter, a meter which shows you sedimentation concentration, and if you calculate the rate of change, there would not be any change of concentration. They just cancel each other. 100 here, because we are moving, minus 2 into 50, just they cancel each other and there is no change. That is why it says apparent change of concentration. Okay. Now, drifting. What is drifting? You just float along the stream. Okay. And in this case, the velocity of the boat is 0. Okay. It is just drifting along the stream. So, velocity of the boat relative to the stream velocity is 0. You add the stream velocity. So, this gives you the velocity of the boat as observed from a stationary observer, which is same as the stream velocity. In this case, the total derivative becomes the substantial derivative. this is a general total derivative. In this case, because the velocity of the boat is same as the velocity of the stream, this concentration what you measure is the substantial derivative of concentration. Okay. That is also an objective which why I took this example, to differentiate between a general dC by dt and capital dC by dt. So, now if you substitute the rate of change of concentration is 100, the velocity now is plus 0.5 into 50 and you would measure 125 ppm per hour. Okay. Now, next you are traveling downstream, you are just traveling along with the stream in your boat, and in this case the velocity of the boat relative to a stationary observer, we will substitute 2.5. Why? The boat is moving in the positive x direction along with the stream. So, plus 2.5, to that add the velocity of the stream which is 0.5, which results in 3 kilometer per hour, and that is the velocity with which the boat moves from a stationary point of view, okay, stationary observer point of view. Now, once again substitute, find out the rate of change of concentration, no longer substantial again, some other velocity. So, 100 here and this velocity is 3 here, this is gives you this value of 250 ppm per hour. So, now you observe different rates of concentration depending on your velocity, which is the velocity of the in this case the velocity at which you are traveling in the boat. So, for travel upstream, all these velocities are related to the stationary observer, minus 2 kilometer per hour, and the dC by dt was just 0. And for the case of drifting, the velocity with respect to stationary observer is 0.5, and now it is substantial derivative of concentration, 125 ppm per hour. For travel downstream, the velocity is 3 and the rate of change of concentration is 250 ppm per hour. So, the observed rates of change differ because the observer is convected at different velocities. Okay. He is moving at different resulting velocities, he is no longer moving at the same velocity of the fluid. So, at different velocities, that is the reason you are observing different and convective changes may add to or subtract the first term and second term based on the velocity, either can add or subtract. Okay. And that is what we have seen, it could either subtract or it could add as well, that depends on the condition we have. So, convective change, the second term may add to or subtract from the local rate of change, that is the first term. Okay. So, that is a very nice example, illustrates several aspects of substantial derivative and total derivative also, either to measure sediment concentration or the fish concentration, could be pollutant concentration, could be temperature. Just to summarize, we have discussed to put it short only two words, substantial derivative, a derivative following the motion. More importantly, the Lagrangian derivative in terms of Eulerian variables, and it has two components to it, the local component and convective component. Okay. So, let us continue in the next lecture.